And a very pleasant good evening to you here from the Duluth Heritage Sports Center in frigid Duluth, Minnesota. Care 11 and MN Hockey TV's Hockey Night in Minnesota. We are so glad to be bringing it to you live here on YouTube. Will Peterson here on the call for a good one. The Hermantown Hawks, as they are on the ice now, they travel down the short jaunt. It would be Central Avenue to take on Duluth Denfeld Hunters, a rematch of last year's Section 7A title game in which Hermantown, they scored and they scored early. Six first period goals en route to a 11-0 win over the Duluth Denfeld Hunters. Current junior Dallas View, the Penn State commit, had a hat trick in that win, in that just that first period, actually, a natural hat trick for the kid. Duluth Denfeld on the other side on the year, 4-2-1. Coming off of a 3-1 win over Superior, a team that they had previously lost, a little bit of a revenge game there for the Hunters. Head coach Dale Jago, always a strict tactician, big-time discipline guy. Three pillars of the Duluth Denfeld Hunters: respect, accountability, and discipline. They're going to have to play a very disciplined game if they want to beat the Hermantown Hawks here tonight. In fact, this has actually been the last three Section 7, as now Duluth Denfeld joins the ice. Last three Section 7A title games have been between the Hermantown Hawks and Duluth Denfeld Hunters. 2022, Hermantown won 11-0. 2021, Hermantown won on their home ice in that weird little COVID year, 8-1. And then in 2020 at the Amsoil, Hermantown, after leading only 1-0 through the first two periods, ended up winning that game as well by a wide margin. Should be a good one here today. Hermantown coming this one 3-0-1, coming off a nice win, 9-1 over Duluth Marshall. We're going to send you down to ice level for these starting lineups and pregame festivities. We'll be right back here on the Edmonton Hockey Night in Minnesota, presented by Carolina. Before the game starts,
and number
Pre-game festivities have concluded. We are just moments away from 51 minutes of high school hockey here in the Northland. The Hermantown Hawks wearing their road navies with the white lettering gold trim. They will skate from right to left on your television set, your mobile screen, however you are tuning in here tonight. Goaltender Darren Upsall. He has won back the starting job, it would seem, from Dane Calloway. Upsall has made the last few starts for this Hermantown team. He got the start the opening weekend for the Hawks against Hill Murray. Hasn't looked back. 2-0-1 on the year. 1.58 goals allowed and a .909 save percentage. One of the better goaltending tandems you'll see in the state. On the other side, Duluth Denfeld will skate from left to right on your television screen, wearing their home whites with the maroon numbers and the gold trim. In goal for them tonight, the junior, Connor Doyle, 2-1-1, a 2.15 goals allowed, and a .929 save percentage. Both sides with some lethal top-end talent. For Duluth Denfeld, their top line tonight, Andy Larson, someone who might be making himself a sneaky Mr. Hockey candidate. 23 points already on the year for Larson. He is paired with the exchange student Artu Molberg, as well as the senior Caden Polso, has skated 4 years of varsity. For the Hawks, it's the Kalpinen brothers alongside Wyatt Carlson as Kate Kohansky still nurses a wrist injury. We're underway, Hockey Night in Minnesota. We're so glad you joined us here. Off the draw, Hermantown wins it cleanly, plays it up ahead. This one's actually gonna go the distance. We'll have icing here, it's 16:50 to go. Faceoff will come deep in the Hermantown zone with the goaltender, Garen Upsall. The rest of the top guys for this Hermantown team. On defense, George Peterson, the captain, will wear the C, trying to become the fifth state championship captain. And on the other side is Will Estabrooks. For Duluth Denfeld, Brayden Erickson starts on defense. And he is joined by Brady McGinn. Off the draw, Matt Kalpinen chips it ahead. Here's Wyatt Carlson now for Josh Kalpinen. Kalpinen, Matt Kalpinen for Wyatt Carlson. He sends this one high. Near the Luth Denfeld bench now. Out to center, George Peterson. Backhand flip, Estabrooks. Out through center, tries to find Josh Kalpinen. It's held down that time by Molberg. Molberg up ahead for Larson. Now it comes free in front of the goaltender, Upsall. Will Estabrooks takes over on the forehand. Now backhand. He shook his man that time. It was Tyler Stewart. Will Estabrooks works it on the forehand. Tries to go short side on Doyle. Misses. Another pause here, 16:10 to go. This one will stay in the zone. It was deep to be deflected. First shot on goal for this Hermantown team. Again, 3-0-1, the reigning Class A state champions in the state of Minnesota. Nice win over Warroad, 3-2. They graduate seven guys. They also lose three to early departures, both the Plant brothers as well as Ty Hansen. Luth Denfeld on the other side graduate a whole host of characters. The McClures, as well as one early departure in the form of Whitaker Hart. Working into the zone, Dallas View on the forehand. Recently bumped down to that second line, just trying to conjure some more offense from the depth for Hermantown. View was previously skating on the first line with Kohansky and Carlson. Now it's Kalpinen's on the forehand, working it in front for those View that time. Swenson crashes. Here comes free to the point, Drew Nelson. Nelson stops, starts, find his partner, Henry Peterson, brother of George Peterson. Down low for View, Swenson crashes on the play. This one comes back out to center, a little backhand poke at it there. Henry Peterson, he's gonna enter here on the forehands, got some room. Sends a shot on, misses just wide, comes free into the corner, River Freeman. Near the Luth Denfeld bench, works it up to the point. Chopping at that time, Jacob Jarby, the senior forward. This one sent the distance for icing, 15:11 to go. We're scoreless here on Minnesota Hockey TV's Hockey Night Minnesota. Hockey Night Minnesota is presented by Affinity Plus Federal Credit Union. Great products, people, and competitive rates. And that's a banking hat trick. Learn more at affinityplus.org. To the glove hand side, Doyle draws one cleanly by Duluth Denfeld. Play back, Brady McGinn's gonna try to rim it around, comes free to the near side. Battle of the sevens as Wick and Gunderson come together. Gunderson currently controls it on the backhand, plays it down for Sundbaum. Mason Sundbaum behind the net. Now here's Gunderson, sharp angle look, trying to find Evian in front. Luth Denfeld will work it back. looking at that time now over the line. Here's Nolan Harju. Harju centering pass, trying to find Jarvie. Hawks will work it back. Evan Gunderson, one of the breakout studs for this Hermantown squad. Aaron Evian takes a huge hit near the dead foul bench. Bone crushing hit from Braden Erickson, the junior defenseman, absolutely lays out Aaron Evian. This one's off to a physical start. Bowman, touch pass miscommunication with Wyatt Carlson. Nolan Barker sent off the puck, poked back by Darren Upsall. Josh Kalpman, that one comes free up to the point. Braden Erickson holds it in, comes free behind now. Larson in there with Weston Bowman. Free, here's Wyatt Carlson now, full head of steam. He's got Josh Kalpman with him. 2-on-1 across Kalpman, scores! Josh Kalpman, the 2-on-1 with Wyatt Carlson. Settles down the pass, sends it home. His team leading 6th goal of the season. Josh Kalpman, Hermantown 1, Duluth Denfeld 0. Josh Kalpman, the junior forward. An increased role this year, and especially now with the injury to Cade Kohansky, his 6th of the year. Comes at the 2:59 mark of this contest. The assist to Wyatt Carlson. What a start for the Hermantown Hawks. They lead 1-0. Now Duluth Denfeld working it back. Carlson heads him off at the pass. He's got Josh Kalpman down low. He's going to work it behind goaltender Doyle. Carlson comes free up top. Keith Denfeld works back. Jake Farrow. Upsall settles it down. Will Esterbrook's on the wheel. Touch pass for Wyatt Carlson. He's got all kinds of space. Sends it back. Now looking again for Carlson that time. It's Sam Swenson. Recent return from a shoulder injury. Sam Swenson back in the lineup. It's a good sign for the Hawks. Gives them some much needed depth. And he's playing a mighty fine role as the F1 on this forecheck. Holding up Andy Larson as he tries to break it out. That one, I believe, went off of the scoreboard here. We'll pause here. 13:01 to go here. Hockey Night in Minnesota is also presented by St. Cloud State University. Explore ideas, seek out unique perspectives, and embrace new challenges. Unleash possibilities. Learn more at www.stcloudstate.edu. Off the draw, Denfeld controls. Played by McGinn, rims it for Postal. Comes out to center, Will Esterbrooks. Touch pass, he tried to find Swenson. This one will go in. Swenson, heavy pressure on the forecheck. He's in there with Nick McGilvery. McGilvery scored his first varsity goal last year against this same Hawks team. Comes up to the point, Esterbrooks. That one was deflected in front, and that hurt. Caden Postal took that one straight to the skate. That could not have felt good. Tripped up that time is Andy Larson. River Freeman to the box, tripping the call. 12:27 to go. Duluth Denfeld will get their first chance on the power play. Sophomore forward, River Freeman to the box, tripping. Time at the penalty. 4:33, basic arithmetic, still staying with me. This Duluth Denfeld power play of 25%. Get their first chance of the night against this Hermantown penalty kill. One of their strong points on this year, 93.3% for this Hermantown team. Caden Postal, Matt Kalpman on the dots. Postal wins it to the point. Andy Larson. Larson works it behind. Now there's John Scott. Scott, pressure from Peterson. Peterson rims it all the way around. They can't quite hold the zone. Now a potential odd man chance for Hermantown as Carlson catches up with it. Has Matt Kalpman in front. Ops keeping himself on the backhand up to the point, Will Esterbrooks, and he's just going to take his time. 12 minutes left here in this one. He's going to send it deep. It's going to rim all the way around. And the Hawks forwards, will go off for a change. Luth Denfeld regroups. Far side, Andy Larson weaves his way. Pickpocketed that time by Josh Kalpanen. Kalpanen sent off the puck there by Brady McGinn. Good defensive play getting back there. McGinn to prevent a breakaway chance. Minute 13 left on the power play for Duluth Denfeld. Larson tries to bring it up again. Too fast for Josh Kalpanen. Larson to the backhand, stripped by Will Esterbrooks. Nice play there from the junior defenseman. That one's played by a high stick. And Aaron Evian with the pressure on that one forces John Scott to touch up. 11:28 to go. Hermantown off to an early 1-0 lead by way Josh Kalpinen on the MN Hockey TV Hockey Night in Minnesota. Tell you what, with this game being so close to Christmas, a little bit of a homecoming here for these two sides, both for Hermantown and Duluth Denfeld. Seeing a lot of old faces from over the years, both on the Hermantown and Duluth Denfeld side. Put a few comedians in attendance here tonight. Sending it on goal, Upsall will stick it aside into the far side corner. Sending it around, there is McGilvery. Back onto the near side, Brady Wick trying to hold the zone. It comes free again for McGilvery. Pressure from Ford Skye to the freshman. 35 seconds left of power play time. Duluth Denfeld haven't even been able, they haven't gotten one shot. Not a lot of high scoring, high opportunity scoring chances. Denfeld controls on the far side. Jake Farrow, touch pass up ahead. They're going to dump this one in. Go for a change, Nolan Harju. Henry Peterson will take his time here, working up through center. 15 seconds left on the man advantage. Peterson over the line. Near side, it's face-off dot. Backhand flip down for Skyda. Skyda is just going to drop that off, no one in particular, although Sam Swenson ends up being the first one on the scene. Works into the slot on the backhand. Shot still loose in front. Ford Skyda crashes, and it's loose behind the net. Hermantown has returned to full strength. High-quality scoring chance there from Ford Skyda. Can't quite put it home. This one goes the distance. Drew Nelson there. Plays it for Peterson. Henry Peterson. Andy Larson holds it in. Now Sam Swenson up for Dallas View. View, touch pass around. Here's a chance for the Hawks. View on the backhand. Going to try to get the edge. Centering pass looking for Swenson. And it comes free again. Now here's Larson back. He's got Mulberg with him. Drops it for Mulberg. Stick save made. Upsall his first real chance of the night. Swenson, here's Bowman on the near side. Weston Bowman, whole lot of space, near side dot. Tries to touch it behind for View. Comes free to the corner. View, should I say Bowman with pressure from Larson. And behind the net again, here's River Freemish off that penalty. Centering pass into the slot, Dallas View. Couldn't quite control it, gets it back, now loses it again to Andy Larson, who dumped it and go off for a change. They might catch him with their pants down here on a big change, but they don't. Near side, near the red line, Freeman tries to send it in, but can't. Intercepted, now taken up by Jacob Jarby near the scoring booth. Brady McGinn sends this one the distance. Coach Andrews asking for an icing, doesn't get it. And back out to center now is Denfeld. Brady Wick sends it in. Barker, stretch pass, he tried to find Carlson, would have had him in on a breakaway. 8:54 to go here, Hermantown, an early 1-0 lead. Faceoff will come deep into the Hermantown zone. Hockey Night in Minnesota is also presented by Red and Black Leagues. Red Black Hockey Spring and Fall Leagues for high school boys and girls. Fall Leagues for Bantam and Pee Wee since 2014. Red and Black has provided serious hockey players an opportunity to improve their game. Red Black Hockey, check them out at redblackhockey.com. Off the faceoff, working it up through center, intercepted that time, taken in the zone by John Scott. Will Estabrooks on the forehand now. Estabrooks, full head of steam through center, weaves through the defense, tries to flip it up ahead for Matt Kalpin and bumped off there by McGinn. Working it behind the goaltender Doyle, Peterson takes over. Chips it up ahead, nobody home. McGinn will take over again for Duluth Denfeld. That one is going to actually hit the linesman. Good break there for Hermantown. As Jake Farrow is heading down the wing with full head of speed. Settling it down and breaking it out, here is Wick. And this one will go the distance as well. Icing, 8:13 to go here in the first period. Hermantown 1, Duluth Denfeld 0 on MN Hockey TV's Hockey Night in Minnesota. If you haven't yet seen the final from our first game here today, it was a 5 o'clock start at the Heritage Sports Center. Duluth East, what many are calling the upset of the year, they take down Andover in convincing fashion, 5-1. Noah Tang, the stud in that one, 2 goals, 1 assist. Big, big showing for Duluth East, trying to scratch and claw their way back into 7AA relevancy, and they might have just done that. Sunbaum works it behind a wraparound look. Puck still loose in front. Sunbaum has again. Shot sent on. Stomach save made by Doyle. Connor Doyle makes his 5th and 6th saves of the night. Stands tall. Mason Sunbaum had the wraparound chance, and then once again it came free into the slot. Sends it on. And it's a stomach save made by the junior goaltender, Connor Doyle. Connor Doyle has more or less won this job. Duluth Denfeld has a pair of senior goaltenders, Peter Smith and Marty Hoffman is now. Here's a chance in front. Aaron Ebion sets a sharp angle look on and comes free for Mason Sundbaum. Evian behind, trying to find Gunderson, comes free into the corner. But Duluth Denfeld has those two experienced goalies, Peter Smith and Martin Hoffman, but Connor Doyle, who came on in relief in last year's Section 7 title game after goaltender Austin Wick was pulled after the first. Doyle appears to have won the job, and he's been stellar so far here this year. 2-1-1, 2.15 goals against, 9.29 save percentage. He has looked the part of a high school hockey starting goaltender. And a good performance here tonight would certainly bolster that as well. Stick broke on the near side. Nick McGilvery seemed to just snap off in his hands. He goes off for a new one. Puck comes free to the point. Drew Nelson near side works onto the backhand. Had Swenson if he wanted him. Opts to just turn it up. Swenson's going to head back down and receive this one. Touch pass ahead for Dallas Hugh. Not sure if he was expecting that one. It's taken over by Braden Erickson. Erickson can't clear. Freeman, nice bank pass behind for Sam Swenson. Centering look is deflected in front. It's Brady McGinn getting a stick on it that time. Comes free to the point again for Henry Peterson. Backhand clear in. Erickson in there with Swenson. Hermantown, sustained zone time. Swenson, where's a hit? Still coming back from that shoulder surgery. Probably not where he wants to be physically. Icing is waved as they rule that Henry Peterson could have got to that one. He's going to break it up here. Peterson for Vue. Nice chip in by Vue. A high arcing puck. It will find its way into the zone. Clearing attempt from Duluth Denfeld. They haven't played much on the Hermantown side of the red line. But to their credit, 11 minutes in, they've limited the Hawks to just the one goal. Not a ton of high-quality chances. This is played back down for Josh Kalpman. Only goal so far here today. Tries to center it for Wyatt Carlson, and then Matt Kalpman, his brother, had a poke at it. Centering look from Matt Kalpman. Wyatt Carlson comes free near side, high slot. Bowman sent that one in off the end boards. And it's into the far side corner again. Wick in there with Josh Kalpman. Comes free. Not for long, however, as it's sent back into the zone. Puck deflects off Wyatt Carlson. Nolan Barker can't hold the zone. Hawks in the middle of line change. And a deep clear is going to go off the netting. There's a big collision there at center ice between Evan Gunderson and John Scott. Got some oohs and ahs from the crowd. 5:23 to go here in the first period. Faceoff will come back to center ice on Minnesota Hockey TV's Hockey Night Minnesota, presented by Care 11. Still just one penalty so far here in this one. River Freeman went off for a minor, successfully killed off by Hermantown, bolstering that already impressive 93.3% penalty kill. Off the draw, Duluth Denfeld plays it back. Tyler Stewart breaking it up. Here's Andy Larson. So dangerous if you give him any kind of space. Larson, long shot. Seen all the way. Glove down by Garrett Upsall. Upsall's third save of the night. It'll be a face-off to his glove hand side once again. 5:11 to go here in the first. Caden Postal and Ford Skyda on the dots, and Postal tried to pull that one back before Skyda was sent out. Aaron Evian will take his place, the senior forward. Postal wins it cleanly to the point, sent out by McGilvery. Stick save made by Upsall, comes free near the Hermantown bench. Battling for it, the 22s come together. It's Postal and Peterson breaking it out now as the Hawks. Aaron Evian on his forehand. Poked off, the Hawks are offside. They're gonna have to tag up. Andy Larson with control. Larson over the line. On his backhand, tries to get around Esterbrooks. Nice play by Esterbrooks as Larson looks to center and it comes free near side boards. I think they're going to get Esterbrooks for holding. Yes, they are. I thought Esterbrooks had played that cleanly. I thought wrong. Esterbrooks of the Hawks for holding. He impeded Andy Larson. 4:41 left. Second power play opportunity for Duluth Denfeld. Time of that penalty will be 12:19. And Duluth Denfeld coming into this 25% on the power play. 0-for-1 so far here tonight. They're going to try to get something going again. Now Andy Larson is actually going to be the de facto quarterback of this power play. If you ask any of his opponents what skill sticks out the most there from Larson, it's his vision. So it makes a lot of sense that Duluth Denfeld would have someone of his vision up there at the quarterback spot. Postal and Kalpinen on the dots. It's actually won by Kalpinen, but it was precariously placed into the slot before Peterson can clear it the distance. Wyatt Carlson, the F1 on that forecheck. The penalty kill forecheck. So much speed does Wyatt Carlson have as now Larson works it back. He's got a fair bit of zone speed, works on the backhand. Has a man in front, can't quite center it for him. He's just going to opt to keep it behind. Larson circles up top, plays it down for Caden Postal. Back to the point, Larson. Active stick there. Matt Kalpanen comes free to the point again. Here's a chance. Postal centering look. He tried to find Molberg in front. Artu Molberg, the Finlander. And it's actually sent into the Hermantown bench. 4:02 to go. A minute 22 left on the Estabrooks holding minor. The faceoff comes from the blocker side of Garen Upsall. Hockey Night Minnesota presented by Meta Sports League. Check out their Meta Buttes NFT Hockey Project, which is a collection of 9,997 Meta Buttes. Learn more at MetaButtes.com. That one sent loose in front. Battle for it. Mason Sundbaum sends the distance. Sundbaum was injured in the, I should say it's two Saturdays ago now with the snow wipeout, but Sundbaum took a hit up high, had a pretty nasty cut in the chin. Good to see him back skating a regular shift for the Hawks. 55 seconds left on the man advantage for Duluth Denfeld. Nice clear there from George Peterson. He'll head the distance. Shot 7-4 in favor of Hermantown. They've been handicapped by a couple early penalties. But they lead here 1-0 behind Josh Kalpanen, sixth of the year. Erickson drops it off for Larson. Larson through center for Molberg. Molberg on the backhand, battle there with Drew Nelson. As the eights come together, Henry Peterson comes down behind the net. Not sure Upsall saw that one. It's still loose in front. Whistle is blown. Upsall had that one the whole way right in front of him. Now some extracurricular activity out front. Now Coach Andrews pleading that faceoff should come outside, and I don't think he's going to get his wish. Regardless, nice play there by Garen Upsall. Seals the post. And smothers the rebound. His fifth save of the night. 3:05 to go. 25 seconds. Power play. Kalpanen wins it back into the corner. Barker gets down low. Now Carlson will clear this one. Wolberg lost his stick in the process. Luth Denfeld, one final push. Kalpanen will send this one down. Packed student body tonight for the Luth Denfeld crowd. Not sure if I can say the same for Hermantown. Pretty good crowd on hand here for this one. Hermantown returns to full strength. Andy Larson drops it down for Postal. Hermantown moves to 2-for-2 on the PK. Now View stretch pass and tried to find Carlson. It was knocked out with a skate there by McGinn. That one banks off behind the goaltender Upsall. Freeman with time. Luth Denfeld. And a line change. Tried to stretch it up for View, and it was knocked down that time by Nolan Hartju. Nelson's going to wheel. Finds Swenson. Swenson fans on the pass. Loses it out through center. Flipped into the zone. Hartju corralled by the other number 12, Nolan Barker. They're going to be offside. Jake Farrow, the offending party that time. 2:04 to go here in the first. This faceoff will come out to neutral. Again, Hermantown going with Upsall, the senior in goal tonight. I'm not sure how many times in high school hockey history have we had a state championship winning goaltender essentially get replaced by his backup at this juncture in the season, but that's essentially what's happened here in Hermantown as Garen Upsall has earned the starting job. On the other side, Luth Denfeld, after having either three or four very, very good years from Jacob Snyder in goal. Last year they started Austin Wick, and now with Wick departed, they turn to Connor Doyle between the pipes. Minute 30 to go here. George Peterson careful not to touch that puck as to avoid a too many men penalty. Good work there by Freeman to deflect that one. Luth Denfeld will regroup. Nick McGilvery here. Stretch pass up ahead through center. Peterson gloves it down. 2-on-1 chance. Larson on the forehand. Great stick play by Peterson. Now he's in there with Caden Postal. And Freeman pokes it ahead. Great play there by Peterson to prevent the offensive attack from Andy Larson. Far side, Evan Gunderson in there with Brady Wick. We passed the 1 minute mark here. Dare I call it a very evenly paced first period. Here's a chance in front for Evan Gunderson. Backhand look for Skyda. Nice save made by Doyle. But aside from the two power plays and maybe the first couple minutes, a little bit of shell shock on Blue Denfeld's side with the Josh Kelman goal, but I would say Blue Denfeld has settled in nicely. Shots now 9-5 in favor of Hermantown, but Denfeld has stayed within themselves. They've been disciplined so far, something that Dale Jago definitely wanted to see coming into this one. And I, as happy as you can be going into an intermission, being down, I think Dale Jago is pretty pleased with his squad's efforts. Jake Farrow in with Matt Kalpinen now. A late change as Tyler Stewart heads off. Off the draw, taken by Josh Kalpinen, centering up the slot. Now here's Will Esterbrook's long shot on, tried to snipe the blocker side to Doyle. Comes free again for Peterson. He's just going to turn fire. Comes free near side corner. And Larson will play it there. Now reversing it to the far side. Carlson, big hit there near the Denfeld bench. Peterson can hold the zone. They're going to have to tag up, and they do so successfully. Comes free for Andy Larson. Nice tip that time. As Upsall settles it down for Peterson. 16 seconds now. Chance loose in front. Big save made by Upsall. Andy Larson was crashing that time. Upsall with a huge save. His sixth of the night. And now he's going to glove down this one as it deflects into the zone. Will Esterbrooks, 3 seconds left. Here's Carlson. One last chance. Carlson, blocker save made by the goaltender Doyle. A flurry of activity to conclude the first period of play here at the Heritage Sports Center. After 17 minutes, Hermantown, an early 1-0 lead behind Josh Kalpinen's team-leading sixth goal of the game. We're going to take a short break. We'll be back here with the first period summary here on Care 11 and Emmett Hockey TV's Hockey Night in Minnesota.
Behind every world-class athlete, there's a team who takes extra care to support them. At Affinity Plus, we take extra care with all your banking goals, from checking accounts to credit cards. Our biggest victory? Helping you win in the ways that matter most. Affinity Plus.
Your college experience begins with your dream. Your time at St. Cloud State will uniquely be your own, but your journey will be guided by our community. Be you. Be bold. Be a Husky.
They say good things come to those who wait, but greatness, that's a different beast. It doesn't come when it's called. It won't wander up to those who do nothing. You have to bait it with the sweat you leave on the ice. You gotta push through the pain. Smile through every ache. And suffer every shift. You gotta chase it. All in the name of the game you love. Because greatness comes to those who take it.
Sniper's Edge Hockey is your one-stop shop for your at-home hockey training needs on and off the ice. Find the perfect start to your at-home training area with slick tiles, synthetic ice, or a rink liner. Or upgrade your home setup with one of our top quality training tools to help you work on soft hands, all of your deeks and dangles, perfect your one-timer, and improve the power and accuracy of your shot. Find it all online and in stock for immediate shipping at snipersedgehockey.com.
Thank you. if there was a place where everything was hockey?
Oh, I need to skate. Here comes Steve's in on goal all alone.
In Minnesota, there is.
Scores!
Welcome you back here at the Duluth Heritage Sports Center after 17 minutes of play. Hermantown skates to an early 1-0 lead over Duluth Enfield. Will Peterson back here on the call. Just one score in the first period. 2:59 into it, Josh Kalpanen with Wyatt Carlson on the 2-on-1. Carlson finds Kalpanen, beats the goaltender Doyle. No secondary assist, that's how we get to 1-0. Two penalties on the period, both on Hermantown. River Freeman, 4:33 in for tripping, 2 minutes. Killed successfully, and then Will Estabrooks for holding on that Andy Larson rush. 2 minutes as well. First period shots for Hermantown, 11. And for Duluth Denfeld, 6. Goaltender saves. Connor Doyle, Duluth Denfeld, 10 saves, 11 chances. For Hermantown's Garen Upsalt, 6 saves on 6 chances. We're going to send you back to break. When we return, we will have 17 more minutes of high school hockey here on Care 11's Hockey Night Minnesota, presented by MN Hockey TV. We'll see you in a bit.
Behind every world-class athlete, there's a team who takes extra care to support them. At Affinity Plus, we take extra care with all your banking goals, from checking accounts to credit cards. Our biggest victory? Helping you win in the ways that matter most. Affinity Plus.
Your college experience begins with your dream. Your time at St. Cloud State will uniquely be your own, but your journey will be guided by our community. Be you. Be bold. Be a Husky.
They say good things come to those who wait. But greatness, that's a different beast. It doesn't come when it's called. It won't wander up to those who do nothing. You have to bait it with the sweat you leave on the ice. You gotta push through the pain. Smile through every ache. And suffer every shift. You gotta chase it. All in the name of the game you love. Because greatness comes to those who take it.
Sniper's Edge Hockey is your one-stop shop for your at-home hockey training needs on and off the ice. Find the perfect start to your at-home training area with slick tiles, synthetic ice, or a rink liner. Or upgrade your home setup with one of our top-quality training tools to help you work on soft hands, all of your deeks and dangles, perfect your one-timer, and improve the power and accuracy of your shot. Find it all online and in stock for immediate shipping at snipersedgehockey.com.
Thank you.
What if there's a place where everything was hockey?
Oh, I need to skate. Here comes Steve and I go all alone.
In Minnesota, there is.
Scores!
We'll be right back.
We'll get back here at the Duluth Heritage Sports Center in beautiful Duluth, Minnesota, on the shores of Lake Superior. Care 11 and MN Hockey TV's Hockey Night in Minnesota. It's been a good one so far here through 17. Duluth Denfeld and Hermantown. After 17, Hermantown leads 1-0 behind Josh Kalpinen's team leading 6th goal of the season. That's the only goal so far here. Single assist went to Wyatt Carlson on the play. So Kalpinen, his 6th, still doesn't have any assists on the year as Hermantown's welcome back to the ice. Josh Kalpinen, his 6th. The feed from Wyatt Carlson at 2:59. Two penalties, River Freeman tripping at 4:33. Will Esterbrooks for holding at 12:19. Duluth Denfeld, very, like I said earlier, very disciplined game here in the early going. Something that, you, quite frankly, if you're Denfeld and you want to beat Hermantown, you're going to have to play a disciplined game. That's plain and simple. It's facts of life. Darren Upsall, very solid so far in goal, as well as Connor Doyle on the other side. Upsall, 6 saves on all 6 chances. And for Connor Doyle, 10 saves, 11 chances. Only goal that was scored. He was really just beat cleanly. That is where we are at. Hermantown back out here. They will be skating from left to right on your television screen or your mobile platforms. However you are joining us here tonight, plethora of ways to do so. Darren Upsall in goal. And for Duluth Denfeld, they will be skating from right to left. Connor Doyle between the pipes. Again, Denfeld skating right to left, wearing their home whites with the maroon lettering. Not quite sure if it's a gold, but definitely a yellow trim for this Duluth Denfeld squad. Early impressions for Duluth Denfeld. Using the last change could really be the difference maker for them. I've been very impressed by the Andy Larson line, along with Caden Postal and Artu Molberg. If they get a chance to roll that line against maybe the second or third lines of Hermantown, that could be a difference maker. As for Hermantown, outside of those first few minutes when you maybe have the shell shock factor from Blues Denfeld against playing such a skillful and speedy opponent, just really not as zippy or snappy as we saw them in the second period against Luth Marshall, where they had 8 unanswered. I'm sure Coach Andrews has made his adjustments in the Hermantown locker room, as well as Coach Jago on Blues Denfeld's side. Both sides will have the long change here for the second period. Should be a good one. Top lines remain the same. Larson and Matt Kalpinen on the faceoff dot. 17 more minutes of high school hockey here in the Northland, and we are so glad that you have joined us. Hermantown wins the draw cleanly. Will Esterbrooks will possess. And that's going to be a penalty once again. 10 seconds into the second period, Andy Larson's tripped up in neutral ice. And Duluth Denfeld will return to the power play where they are 0-2 so far. Tonight it'll be Will Esterbrooks once again with the infraction. Just got his stick caught up in Andy Larson. I tell you what, even though he hasn't been on the score sheet tonight, Andy Larson sure does make things happen. 12 goals, 23 assists on the year for Larson. 10 seconds into the second, Duluth Denfeld will return to the power play. George Peterson will control now for the Hawks. Spins and fires, intercepted by the other number 22, Caden Postal, works it over the line. And back to the near side, Wyatt Carlson tries to clear, but can. It's held in at the point by McGinn. Now comes back out the center. Postal will have it again. Reverses the field to the far side. John Scott now drops it down low for Andy Larson. Larson, pressure from Wyatt Carlson. And he's just going to stop and... Actually, he's going to drop it off for Brady McGinn, who's going to lead this charge. Larson near the Hermantown bench. Pressure from Matt Kalpinen. Nice pass to the far side, John Scott. Scott works it. Now he's just going to drop it for Postal. Near the neutral ice. Now the Hawks back. Carlson pokes it up ahead. Peterson goes out for a change. Here's a chance for Denfeld to catch him in a change. Larson over the line through center. Tripped up again. No call. Might have been under his own weight. Going to rim this one around. Drew Nelson, first one there for the Hawks. That's Josh Kalpinen. He's going to backhand clear. This one will go the distance. 48 seconds left on the power play here. The regroup for the Denfeld Hunters. 25% on the power play coming into tonight. 0-2 so far, looking to make it 1-3. Fumbling with it through neutral ice, Nick McGilvery. Now Henry Peterson shakes a man, and he's going to send this one the distance as well. One final regroup for Duluth Denfeld. Nothing really doing so far here on this power play. They're going to try to change this here on the breakout. Stretch pass up ahead, Brady Wick to the far side. Now Dallas View intercepts, 2-on-1. He's got him with him. View for Kelpinen scores! Josh Kelpinen, another 2-on-1 look, this time with Dallas View. Settles it down, goes from skate to stick. Josh Kelpinen, second of the game, 7th of the year. Shorthanded Hermantown 2, Duluth Denfeld 0. Great start to the second period for the Hawks after losing Will Esterbrooks to a penalty. Still 10 seconds left on the penalty kill for the Hawks, but a big shorthanded tally from Josh Kalbanen, second of the game, 7th of the year. It's 2-0 Hermantown. This one will go the distance. River Freeman, first man on, tries to send a sharp angled shot on as Hermantown returns to full strength. Now we're going to get the goal announcement here. Josh Kalbanen, single assist to Dallas View. Time of the goal, 2 minutes elapsed in the second. Hermantown works it back again. That's been a characteristic of this Hermantown team as Swenson works it inside. Sharp angle look. Nice save made. Doyle sealed the post. This one's going to be rimmed around. Skyda, first man there. He's got Swenson low. Now Swenson's going to be bumped off the puck by Brady McGinn. Andy Larson in to help out. In with Ford Skyda. Good strip by Skyda into the high slot. It's going to work onto the forehand. Stick save made by Doyle. Swenson drops it behind. One-time look. Up the slot, Freeman tried to find Skyda. It'll go the distance. As I was saying, characteristic for this Hermantown squad, slow starting in the first, great second period so far this year. Icing waved here on this one. Braden Erickson. As Denfeld tries to cook something up here. Here's a turnover, working it back the other way. Matthias McMillan works into the high slot, shot sent on. It'll go just wide of the goaltender Upsall. Now behind the play. Here's Henry Peterson working it through traffic up into neutral. Evan Gunderson pressuring. Little pitch and catch between Luth Denfeld D. Jarvey couldn't settle that one down, went off his skate. Now Peterson for his brother, actually. That's Henry Peterson. Now a chance for the Hawks. Aaron Evian on the forehand. Tries to center it up the slot. Mason Sundbaum comes free for Evan Gunderson near side boards. Sundbaum will control it behind the goaltender Doyle. Evian with pressure. Good start to the second period for the Hawks. Swarming pressure. Haven't conceded a shot on goal even with the penalty kill. It's been everything they could ask for here. Gunderson works into the slot. Glove save made there by Doyle. Comes free near side corner. Now here's Evian behind. Evian pressure from Larson. Andy Larson, he's been everywhere tonight even though he hasn't been on the score sheet. Really does make his presence felt in a variety of ways. Sundbaum, backhand flip, finds the other number 16. There is Larson. Now Sundbaum will glove it down. It's taken over by McGilvery. McGilvery wears an A for this Duluth Denfeld squad, the former Duluth East Greyhound. Nolan Barker, they're offsides that time. He's a little too quick entering the zone. They tag up successfully. Duluth Denfeld trying to break it out again. Intercepted center ice. Here's Wyatt Carlson in with Matt Kalpinen. Carlson, big hit on McGilvery. Wyatt Carlson. Lines up and sends down Nick McGilvery. Hermantown holds it. Bank pass. Carlson again tries to get a little too cute, get around his man Larson. Hunter's back. Postal on the forehand. Tries to center. Comes free high slot. And that is going to be another penalty on the Hermantown Hawks. Caden Postal was hooked that time. And Wyatt Carlson will be the offending party 5 minutes into the second period. It is a fourth chance on the power play for the Duluth Denfeld Hunters. They're 0-for-3 so far. Looking to buck that trend. Carlson to the box. 5 minutes in to the second period. And Duluth Denfeld will get back on the man advantage off the faceoff. One cleanly played to the point for him again. Peterson heads off his man, John Scott. This one's going to go the distance. Doyle will settle it down and then regroup. Carlson for hooking at 5 minutes, 12 minutes remaining. That's how you prefer to keep your score. This one will also head the distance. Larson settle it down. Pressure from Matt Kalpin, the number one penalty killer for the Hawks, even last year alongside Sam Plant. Expect that role to only increase this year. Another year older, another year stronger. Sharp angled look there that time from John Scott. Finds the stomach of Garrett Upsall. Seventh save of the night, seventh chance of the night. Hermantown 2 Duluth, Denfeld 0. 1:27 left on the power play. 4 Duluth, Denfeld 11:27 left in the game. Off the draw, play to the point. Larson, the quarterback for this unit. Nice deflection in front. Larson intentionally shot wide of the net. It was a good deflection by John Scott. Just couldn't quite get on net. I beg your pardon. That was Artu Moberg deflecting that. Got my 18s and 8s mixed up. And Sluth Denfeld back to the breakout. Touch pass up ahead. There's John Scott. A little too far for him, however. Peterson's going to rim it all the way around. Larson will take over near the Hermantown bench. Larson wheels. Pressure from Dallas View. Larson over center, over the line, onto the forehand. Really crafty skater is Andy Larson. He's going to rim this one down and around. And a nice little slap clear that time by Will Esterbrooks. Again, just a one shot on the power play, on this power play, I should say, for Duluth Denfeld. Good work by the Hawks. Penalty kill did not allow much. There's a bad turnover. Dallas View actually couldn't collect that on the stick. Denfeld back. Near side, here's Braden Erickson over the line, into the slot, sends a shot on, goes wide. And now it's Jake Farrow, far side corner, rimming it back behind George Peterson. Pressure from Nick McGilvery, sends this one the distance. Doyle will settle it for Braden Erickson. 27 seconds left in the man advantage, one last gasp for the Denfeld Hunters. The far side, played there by Farrow. Farrow on the backhand, works to the forehand, loses the puck up high. Josh Kalpman sends this one the distance. 12 seconds now. Braden Erickson, junior defenseman, saw some good varsity time last year as a sophomore. Nice pass deflect off the skate of Mason Sunbaum. Icing waved, it was deflected there that time by Matthias McMillan. Played behind the goaltender Upsall. Bank pass up ahead from Mason Sunbaum out to center, dumped in by McGinn. Upsall settles for Henry Peterson. There's Josh Kalpnin geometrically ahead for Wyatt Carlson. Works on the forehand, nice shot sent on, and a stick slash stomach save made by Connor Doyle. 9:36 to go here in the second. Hermantown leads 2-0. Fans, be sure to watch for the True Hockey Play of the Game at the conclusion of this game. That'll be posted on the mnhockey.tv social media platforms. Not sure I've seen one of those plays that has just blown me out of my seat yet as Freeman tries to make one of those plays. But I'm sure there will be more than its fair share of action here down the stretch. We're not even halfway into this game. It's already been a good one. Hermantown 2-0 over Duluth Denfeld. Shots 14-7 in favor of Hermantown. Now they're going to break it out of the zone. River Freeman, full head of steam. Nice play that time by Braden Erickson to bump him off. Sends it up ahead. Caden Postel with Denfeld goes for a full line change. Hawks going to try to use their speed to take advantage. Drew Nelson, full head of steam near side. Bumped off by Andy Larson. He was tangled up with Drew Nelson. Evan Gunderson tries to work to the point. Now he's going to play it back down for Ford Skyda. Puck comes free into the slot. River Freeman didn't see it. And now he will control it on his backhand, sends it down low, tries to find Gunderson. It's going to rim all the way around, find the other number seven. There's Brady Wick. Larson and Skyda doing battle, get along with both of the sevens. Puck comes free near side. Nelson collapses to take it. Freeman takes his place up high. And the eights come together now. Moberg and Nelson comes free to the point. Henry Peterson, long shot, deflected down. Ford Skyda. Works it down low, he's in there with Braden Erickson. Evan Gunderson calls for the puck, gets it. Can't quite settle it down, comes free behind the goaltender Doyle. Larson sends it back around. I believe that one hit something in the Hermantown bench. 8:14 to go, face off out to neutral. Care 11 and Emmett Hockey's Hockey Night in Minnesota. Luth Denfeld and Hermantown. Duluth Heritage. A beautiful venue on the shores of Lake Superior. One of my favorites for high school hockey. Just combines the modern and the historic feel all together. You see the jerseys hanging from the Duluth youth programs. You see Woodland, Glen Avon, Portman, Piedmont. Just a beautiful venue. and one that I believe will stand the test of time. Here's Matt Kelpnen on his forehand. He's got a speed. Kelpnen scores! Matt Kelpnen, full head of steam, beats the goaltender Doyle on his blocker side. He joins the scoring party. Kelpnen's on the board for Hermantown. Matt Kelpnen this time, 3-0 Hermantown over Duluth Benfeld. Matt Kelpnen decided he couldn't let his brother get the best of him. 2 goals for Josh, 1 goal for Matt. Go crazy, Tom Kelpnen. Your boys have put Hermantown up 3-0. 9:02, the time of the goal. Matt Kelpnen from Weston Bowman and Nolan Barker. That's the first varsity point for Weston Bowman. Over the line, shot is sent on and deflected down by Will Esterbrooks. Postal tried to get it in that time. To Molberg over the line here. Molberg's going to work it in. Sent off, and now Molberg's going to head off for a penalty. They clearly impeded George Peterson's ability to play the puck. Holding will be the call. 7:28 to go here in the second period. Hermantown, their first power play chance of the night, operating at a clip of 18.8% on the year. Molberg to the box for holding. Time of the penalty will be 9:32. Andy Larson wins the draw cleanly, plays into the corner. Taken there by Braden Erickson. Here's Matt Kelpnen again, near side dot up high, Will Esterbrooks. Drops for Dallas View. View surveys up again for Esterbrooks. Now View. Hawks trying to work it inside. They're going to drop it low again, Matt Kelpnen. Now across George Peterson. Back Esterbrooks for Peterson again. Peterson, big time power play weapon for the Hawks. Esterbrooks now for View. Hermantown, methodical approach to this power play. Just trying to wear down the defense, get a quality look inside. Peterson from the point, deflected in front. Carlson couldn't get a stick on it. Luth Denfeld gets a clear. Postal sends it the distance. And a full unit change for the Hunters. View will swing here on this one. Over the line, beautiful move in open ice. Now he's going to work it on his forehand. Dallas View, coast to coast. Backhand look, nice save made by Doyle. Now a centering look there from Wyatt Carlson. Nobody was home. Aaron Evian was the intended recipient. Wasn't where he wanted him to be. Another one-time look, scores! Wyatt Carlson couldn't get it home on the first try, but he did on the second. The feed from Dallas View. 6:13 to go, power play goal for the Hermantown Hawks. Wyatt Carlson, his second of the year, Hermantown 4, Luth Denfeld 0. Connor Doyle made the first save, couldn't adjust in time for another point-blank look for Wyatt Carlson. The Hawks' trend of big second periods continues. 3 goals so far here in the second, Josh Kelpnen, Matt Kelpnen. Now Wyatt Carlson, the entire top line for the Hawks is buzzing. 4-0, Hermantown. Carlson, the assist to Dallas View and George Peterson. Time of the goal, 10:47 on the power play. Comes free to the point. Peterson sends it down for Sundbaum. Now here's Evian. Evian is checked down that time by McGinn. Comes free near side corner behind the net. Sundbaum going to try to look for the wraparound. Feeds the point. Henry Peterson. Clap bomb look. Puck still loose. Sundbaum. Check that. That was Skyda jabbing at it. Now it's Sundbaum behind. Puck comes free. Stewart will control. Back out to center come the Hawks. Drew Nelson over the line. Nelson full head of steam on the forehands. Going to try to wrap it. Now a centering look for Mason Sundbaum. And he can't get it home. Good stick that time by Brady Wick. Sundbaum still looking for his first varsity goal. Now he tries to feed the slot for Aaron Evian. This one will go and now is waved. Another full change for Denfeld here. Stretch pass, Nelson finds Skyda. Touch pass ahead now for Dallas View. Out to center. Taken by Molberg. Battle here. River Freeman comes free with it. Freeman tries to work to the backhand. Comes free forward. Skyda. Skyda sends a shot on. Nice pass save. Made Doyle. Centering look for River Freeman. Right in front of the crease. Nobody home. Here's Henry Peterson. Peterson's shot is on and deflected. Up, not quite out of play by Erickson. View tries to get it down low for Swenson. It's taken by Andy Larson. After keeping pace with Hermantown for the first period, and the start of the second, Hermantown's speed starting to prove too much for this Duluth Denfeld defense to handle. Three goals here so far in the second. They're going to look to make it four here. Sam Swenson can't collect it on his forehand. Works it on the backhand in the near side corner. View is going to look. Sharp angled look. Stick from Andy Larson. This one's going to stay in the zone. 4:08 to go in the second period. Hermantown 4, Duluth Denfeld 0. Emin Hockey TV's Hockey Night in Minnesota, presented by Care 11. Hockey Night in Minnesota, also presented by Affinity Plus Federal Credit Union. Great products, people, and competitive rates. Now that is a banking hat trick. Learn more at affinityplus.org. Face off to the glove side of Doyle. Up to the point, Nolan Barker. And that little chip tries, actually, they're going to rule that that was deflected. Ended up in the netting. 4:01 to go now. Well, I tell you what, I don't know if you've had the chance to see Connor Doyle on Mass tonight, but he has one of the best heads of lettuce in the state of Minnesota. Should Duluth Denfeld make their first trip to the state tournament in many moons, I have a feeling we're going to be seeing Connor Doyle in the hockey air video because it is a sight. Shot on now by Kalpinen, comes free to the high slot. Seems like every time I get off on one of those fun little tangents, there's always a scoring chance to derail it, but that's all right. That's not why I'm here. Out to center, Carlson tries to poke it ahead. Now Nick McGilvery for his partner, Brady McGann, who can't settle it down. Here's Wyatt Carlson working on the forehand, and it comes free in front. Duluth Denfeld back with numbers. John Scott, forehand look over the line, high slot, tries to drop it off, comes free. Here's McGilvery. McGilvery, clap bomb, look, rebound, look, score! John Scott settles down the rebound in front. Duluth Denfeld on the board. John Scott is fifth of the year. 4-1, Hermantown. Three on two look for Duluth Denfeld. Puck left at the slot. Nick McGilvery didn't quite get all of it. And John Scott corrals the rebound. Beats the goaltender Upsall. Hermantown 4, Duluth Denfeld 1. John Scott giving this Denfeld crowd something to cheer about. They're back in 3. Give the assist to Nick McGilvery and Jake Farrow. Time to goal, 13:41. For Scott, that is his fifth of the year. Big time contributor for the Denfeld Man of A squad. Now here's Mason Sunbaum trying to get it back. Puck comes free to the far side. Controlled there by Postal again. The goal should read Scott from McGilvery and Farrow, 13:41. Now we get a penalty. And it's going to be a high sticking on Luth Denfeld. Brady McGinn is going to head off. High sticking. 2:48 to go here in the second. Time of that penalty will be 14:12. My basic arithmetic serves me correct. And this Hermantown high-powered power play will get a chance at it once again. They are 1-for-1 so far here today. As Wyatt Carlson found the back of the net, that little rebound look in front of Connor Doyle. 4-1 Hermantown, they're going to look to make a 5-1 here. Now the latest of changes as Nick McGilvery heads off. His stick is broken. And he's going to be replaced by Brady Wick. Larson and Postal, or excuse me, Kalpinen, got my 17s. Cross, Kalpinen and Postal on the dots. Esther Brooks plays near side, Dallas View up high. View's been quiet lately. Let's see if he can get something going here. Up high for George Peterson. To the near side, Will Esther Brooks. Back up top, Peterson. For View, far side. Dot has a look. Nice glove save made by Doyle. View tried to pick his corner. Doyle saw it all the way, gloves it down. 2:29 to go, 1:41 to go. On the man advantage, 4-1 here on Hockey Night in Minnesota. Kalpinen wins the draw back. Estabrooks at the point. Through traffic, stick save made. Doyle, not sure if he even knew where that one went exactly. Good clear that time by Andy Larson. He'll come out to center. Estabrooks will settle it down again. Estabrooks for Dallas View. They're going to work backward now. View far side on the forehand, full head of steam. Going to weave his way through traffic. View off the iron. Dallas View rings the iron. And now he controls it again to the near side corner. Cross crease look, tried to find George Peterson. Hermantown's power play, they really do like to sneak that high guy down low for a little backdoor look. It's worked a couple times so far on the year for the Hawks. Didn't work that time. They couldn't connect. Now here's a chance. Good stick that time by Doyle to send it into the corner. And it comes up to the slot again for Will Estabrooks. Near side, Peterson can't control it. Down low for Kalpinen. Give and go look off the iron again. Hermantown has hit the post twice just in this one shift. Centering look. Wyatt Carlson didn't get all of it. Now it did Connor Doyle on the save. Comes free. Far side corner. View surveys. 33 seconds left on the man advantage. Peterson, far side corner. Circles. Up top, Estabrooks. Looking. Finds View. View down low. Tried to find Kalpinen. And comes free to the corner again. Matt Kalpinen will possess. 106 to go here in the second. Lightning shot from the point. Will Estabrooks might have hit something in front. Doesn't matter. Doyle loves it. 103 to go, 16 seconds left on the man advantage. Hermantown 4, Duluth NFL 1. Face off the blocker side of Doyle. Postal wins it cleanly. This one's going to be cleared and actually held by Freeman before later being cleared by R2 Molberg. Drew Nelson takes over, 4 seconds left. And Luth Denfeld returns to full strength. Aaron Evian, far side, full head of steam, drops into the slot, trying to find Josh Kalpinen. Denfeld works back now. Not for long, however, Barker sends it down. As now it's Josh Kalpinen on the backhand. Kalpinen for Evian, tried to find Barker, and that hit the stick of Brayden Erickson in front. They've had a good time look for Nolan Barker. Bank pass ahead, Wyatt Carlson. Brayden Erickson tries to throw a hit and is unsuccessful in doing so. Larson, one final chance here, 15 seconds left. Trying to find Molberg. Molberg couldn't settle it down. 10.3 ticks to go. Shots 24-8 in favor of Hermantown. They lead 4-1. They're going to have time to draw up some kind of set piece here, something that they've excelled at, getting good looks from their set pieces on the face-off draws. We'll see if they can do something similar here. Kalpinen and Scott. Scott wins it back into the near side corner. Matt Kalpinen settles it. 5 seconds. They've got to get something to net if they want a chance. View backhand look ends up going behind the goaltender. Doyle, that's going to do it. 3 second period of play here at the Heritage Sports Center. After 34 minutes of high school hockey here in the Northland, Hermantown skates to a 4-1 lead over Duluth Denfeld. We're going to take a break. After a few short video messages, we'll be back with a recap of the second period here on KR11 and MN Hike TV's Hockey Night in Minnesota. Be back in just a bit.
Behind every world-class athlete, there's a team who takes extra care to support them. At Affinity Plus, we take extra care with all your banking goals, from checking accounts to credit cards. Our biggest victory? Helping you win in the ways that matter most. Affinity Plus.
Your college experience begins with your dream. Your time at St. Cloud State will uniquely be your own, but your journey will be guided by our community. Be you. Be bold. Be a Husky.
They say good things come to those who wait, but greatness, that's a different beast. It doesn't come when it's called. It won't wander up to those who do nothing. You have to bait it. with the sweat you leave on the ice. You gotta push through the pain. Smile through every ache. And suffer every shift. You gotta chase it. All in the name of the game you love. Because greatness comes to those who take it.
Sniper's Edge Hockey is your one-stop shop for your at-home hockey training needs on and off the ice. Find the perfect start to your at-home training area with slick tiles, synthetic ice, or a rink liner. Or upgrade your home setup with one of our top-quality training tools to help you work on soft hands, all of your deeks and dangles, perfect your one-timer, and improve the power and accuracy of your shot. Find it all online and in stock for immediate shipping at snipersedgehockey.com.
What if there was a place where everything was hockey?
Oh, I need to skate. Here comes Steve's and I go all alone.
In Minnesota, there is.
Scores! Welcome back here from the Heritage Center in Duluth, Minnesota, after 34 minutes of high school hockey. Hermantown has skated to a 4-1 lead over Duluth Benfeld. Will Peterson back here on the call. Let's break down that second period. 2 minutes in, Josh Kalpinen, his second of the night. The assist in Dallas View on that one. Even strength goal for the Hawks. 2 minutes in, 9:02. Matt Kalpinen decided my brother can't be getting all the goals. He adds one of his own. Assist to Weston Bowman and Nolan Barker. Time of that goal, 9:02. 30 seconds later, Duluth Denfeld commits a penalty, which leads to this power play goal from Wyatt Carlson. A little rebound look in front of the goaltender Doyle. Puts the second one home. Assist to Dallas View and George Peterson at 10:47. Duluth Denfeld gets on the board as well. John Scott settles down a rebound. Assist from Nick McGilvery and Jake Farrow. Four penalties in the second period. Two aside, 10 seconds in, Will Estabrooks. What a way to start a period. Commits an infraction, and that infraction would be, if the spreadsheet will load it, is tripping, his second penalty of the game. Hawks kill that off successfully. 5 minutes in, Wyatt Carlson for hooking. And then for Duluth Denfeld, Artu Mulvern, 2 minutes for holding, 9:32. That led to the power play goal from Wyatt Carlson. And at 14:12, Brady McGinn high sticking. That's also a 2 minute minor, but Duluth Denfeld able to kill that one off. Shots in the second period, Duluth Denfeld 2, but they made one of them count. Game total of 8 shots for Hermantown, 13 shots for game total of 24. Second period saves, Connor Doyle, 10 saves on 13 shots, game total of 20 saves for Hermantown's Garen Upsall. One save on 2 shots, game total of 7 saves. Duluth Denfeld 0 for 4 on the power play, Hermantown 1 for 2. on the power play. And that is all we have for you here, folks. Zamboni's making the laps. Just a few short minutes. We will have 17 more minutes of high school hockey for you in the Northland on MN Hockey TV's Hockey Night in Minnesota after two periods. Hermantown 4, Duluth 10, 12, 1. We'll be back in just a minute.
Behind every world-class athlete, there's a team who takes extra care to support them. At Affinity Plus, we take extra care with all your banking goals, from checking accounts to credit cards. Our biggest victory? Helping you win in the ways that matter most. Affinity Plus.
What if there was a place where everything was hockey?
Oh, I need to skate. Here comes Steve's and on goal all alone.
In Minnesota, there is.
Scores!
Welcome you back here at the Duluth Heritage Sports Center in Duluth, Minnesota. 34 minutes. 17 times 2. 34 minutes of high school hockey gone. Here in the Northland, Duluth Denfeld trailing Hermantown. High score of 4-1. Will Peterson back here on the call for Hermant Hockey TV. Their hockey night in Minnesota. What a wonderful program they have, showcasing some of the best games from across the state of Minnesota's Hermantown returns to the ice. I'd like to thank our corporate sponsors, of course, Care 11 for putting this on, Affinity Plus, Federal Credit Union, St. Cloud State University, who is the presenting sponsor here this third period, Red Black League, Meta Sports League, and of course, fans, be sure to watch for the True Hockey Play of the Game, the conclusion of this game that will be posted on the MN Hockey TV social media platforms. I think I've got my pick locked in. I'm not going to reveal it. I'll let you all play along with me at home. I'll have a watchful eye on the Hermant Hockey TV Twitter account tonight. Hermantown will be skating from right to left on your viewing screen. Aaron Upsall returns to his goal wearing number 31. Hermantown wearing their Road Navies white lettering, gold trim. Luth Denfeld yet to join us, but they will be skating from left to right. Now here they are, skating from left to right on your television set, wearing their home whites with the maroon lettering and numbering, and what I have decided to call their yellow trim. Not quite sure if it is gold. Yellow is going to be my operating assumption. Second period scorers, Josh Kalpman at Kalpman and Wyatt Carlson and John Scott. And I don't mean to alarm you folks at home, but if the Kalpman family never existed, this game's tied at one. Of course, I say that satirically, as of course you take away some of the things that make something good. It's no longer as good, but it's been a banner night for the Kalpman household, I'll say that much. Long change is over and done. We'll have a short change here. Both sides attacking away from their benches. Duluth Denfeld, after only mustering two shots in the second period. Granted, one of them did find the back of the net, courtesy of John Scott. I have to wonder what kind of offensive adjustments they're going to be making here. As for Hermantown, I have a sneaking suspicion that Coach Andrews isn't just happy with putting the cruise control on. He wants to tack on a couple more, make this one really, really convincing one. Shots 24-8 in favor of Hermantown. As we get ready for the third period here, Andy Larson and Matt Kalpman on the dots. Kalpman wins it, plays it back for Will Estabrooks. Now there's Peterson, pass is intercepted by Molberg. Denfeld works it back in. Estabrooks behind. From Josh Kalpman, two goals here, finds his brother Matt, hit him actually in the midsection, couldn't quite get that one down. Andy Larson will regroup. Bank pass up ahead, they're gonna be offside. Caden Postle got in a little bit too early. We will pause, 16:32 to go here. This one's actually gonna hit all the way down the where the pass originated, I believe it's off the stick of Andy Larson. Face-off down there. River Freeman out there for the Hawks. Looks like they're, all right, I stand corrected, actually. Freeman is on this second line. Coach Andrews always mixing and matching some guys as the season ebbs and flows, trying to find his right combination as the playoffs begin. Of course, these games will not really matter come February and March, when the Hawks hope to defend their state title. Near side corner, played there by Farrell. At the point, Wick back down, intercepted Dallas View. He's going to just arc this one ahead. Sam Swenson hits him in stride. He's bumped off the puck that time by Brady Wick. Now here's View trying to center it. It's broken up. John Scott back. Only for a moment, however. This one's now fed up to the slot. Drew Nelson works it all the way behind on the backhand. Puts the stop on. Finds View. Near side, sharp angle, a little coffin corner action. Peterson will just send it in back down again, let View fight for it. He wins, and he has it right back where he started in the corner. Works it into the high slot, works it from the backhand to the forehand, finds Nelson. Nelson's going to work it behind now. Drew Nelson circles back up top, now on his forehand to the Knots. Glove save made by Doyle. 15:19 to go on the Minnesota Hockey TV Hockey Night in Minnesota. Presented by St. Cloud State and Care 11. Take a look at some scores from around the state, of course, earlier. Duluth East pulls off a shocker, taking down Andover 5-1. Looking elsewhere, Roseville beats the shocker. Now here's a chance in front for Aaron Ebbian off the mask. Connor Doyle, as they say in Slapshot, he stopped that with his mind. Play will continue here. A little touch over 15 minutes to go. Aaron Ebbian still trying to find that first varsity goal. He's going to possess it now on his backhand. Work to the forehand. Send a shot on. He's tripped in front. They score! Mason Sundbaum settles down the rebound. That's his first varsity goal. Sundbaum, his first game back from injury against Centennial. Dallas View goes, picks up the puck, settles down the air, and Ebbian rebound, Hermantown 5, Duluth 10-1. That one flipped into the bench for safekeeping. That's a moment Sundbaum will remember for some time now. The senior forward, his first varsity goal, 14:55 to go. Hermantown 5, Duluth 10-1. Single assist, Aaron Ebbian on the goal. Sundbaum from Ebbian 2:05. And a hot start to the second period for this Hermantown squad. They've scored within the first 3 minutes of all three periods. See if they can keep the good times flowing here. To the near side, out to center. This one's actually going to head out of play. We'll pause here. Clock strikes 9 here from Duluth Heritage Sports Center. Some more scores from around the state. Roseville takes down Chisago Lakes 4-3. Moorhead. Nice win over a Section 8 opponent. St. Michael Albertville 7-2 the final there. Blaine in progress, beating Hudson, Wisconsin 3-1. Shakopee over Chaska 4-2. They're still in progress. Backdoor look. What a nice find from Will Estabrooks to George Peterson. Can't do the ball. This one will head the distance, and boy, Will Estabrooks just took a shot from Caden Postal into the boards. He's going to be all right. Now this one is going to be sent deep again. Peterson will settle it down. A little too cute with it, turned over. Larson back into the zone. Garrett Upsall vacated his net to venture outward and settle down that puck. Now Wyatt Carlson's going to wheel. Carlson with some space, gets it up ahead for Josh Kalpanen. The 17s come together. Matt Kalpanen, Braden Erickson forces a turnover. Here's Wyatt Carlson. Behind the net on the backhand. Near side corner, going to try to work it up into the slot. Backhand look, stomach save made it, I don't think. Knew where that puck was. Might have even snuck in behind him. Connor Doyle in goal. The whistle is blown. 13:45 to go here. Still Hermantown 5. Both Denfeld 1. Montemedi and Stillwater still in progress on the Emmett Hockey TV stations. Do not have a score for you, but that last check, it was Stillwater 2-1 over Montemedi. Good little rivalry game there. And then Warroad currently beating Thief River Falls 3-0 over at the Ralph. Another barn that I would love to get to someday. Heard great things. Up to the high point. Nice glove save made by Upsall. Jake Farrow with a one-time look in the high slot. Didn't quite catch all of it. A little bit of a fluttering puck. Upsall sees it for his ninth save of the night. That's 10th chance. 13:31 faceoff to Upsall's blocker side. Freeman wins the battle against John Scott. Scott, the lone goal scorer for Duluth Denfeld here tonight. Nelson plays for Henry Peterson. Stretch pass. Swenson tried to find Freeman. Nelson will take over behind the cage. Stretch pass. Here's Dallas View working it over the line into the high slot. Now he's going to work it on his backhand. Trying to send it across the crease looking for River Freeman. Duluth Denfeld will work back. Poking it ahead is John Scott. He tried to find his man, Farrow, unable to do so. Hermantown back. Henry Peterson over the line. Drops for View. Turned over. Here's Scott. Now he's turned over by Sam Swenson for View. View works it inside. Now it's free in the slot. Denfeld gets the clear. Not quite far enough for icing. Nelson will take over. Good pass there to find Freeman, who I think wanted to get a little more on that to send it in, initiate the forecheck. Gunderson intercepts the pass nonetheless, so it serves its purpose. View near the Denfeld bench just turns and fires that one wildly into the corner. Now he's going to go off for a change. Denfeld trying to break it out. There's Seamus Shea. What a name that is. Skating his first shift tonight, the sophomore forward. Connor Doyle is one of the best That's a hair. I would argue that Seamus Shea is one of the better names in the state of hockey. Big pass up ahead. Here's Gunderson. Finds Sundbaum. Working it around his man. What a move, Mason. Sundbaum on his forehand scores! Mason Sundbaum, how do you do? No more than a couple minutes after his first varsity goal, he has his second. Beautiful snipe beats the goaltender Doyle. Hermantown 6, Blues Denfeld 1. Mason Sundbaum in short order gets goals number 1 and 2 of his high school career. 12:01 remaining here in the Heritage Center. Hermantown 6, Blues Denfeld 1. And that, my friends, is going to be, I don't know why I was keeping you all in suspense, but that's going to be my pick for the true hockey play of the game. Hopefully see that one on the Edmonton Hockey TV social platforms tonight, because that was a pretty move by Sundbaum. Drives the net, what a snipe, and that one's going to head up into the concourse. Off the faceoff, R2 Mulburn deflects a stretch pass up in front. The assist goes to Evan Gunderson, who's having a nice year for the Hermantown Hawks. Sundbaum from Gunderson, 4:59. So less than 3 minutes between Mason Sundbaum's first and second high school goals. It's Hermantown 6, Blues Denfeld 1. Sundbaum wins the draw, plays it back. Now Barker for his partner, Bowman. Up ahead, Gunderson, far side, Sundbaum. Can he get a hat trick? That would be a natural hat trick after scoring your first goal in the third period of a pretty tightly contested game, at least leading up to the start of the period, I should say. 11:25, now look at icing. Andy Larson, the one in pursuit. The third period here, presented by St. Cloud State University. Explore ideas, seek out unique perspectives, and embrace new challenges. Unleash possibilities. Learn more at www.stcloudstate.edu. Face off one cleanly to the shooter's slot, taken there by Carlson. Now back behind, taken by Nolan Udd. The bank pass, or should I say bank that one to himself, Jake Farrow up ahead. So here's Estabrooks behind the cage. Tyler Stewart far side, up to the point, Nolan Udd. Driven off the puck, now this one's driven precariously into the slot, nobody home, Hawks back the other way. Josh Kalpinen burning his man, Brady Wick, into the slot. And Matt Kalpinen can't settle that one down. Now they try to find Wyatt Carlson, and his shot goes wide. He has it on the backhand. Hermantown's speed starting to be too much for Duluth Denfeld. Carlson turns, fires, scores! Wyatt Carlson from the slot, turns and fires. Doyle couldn't save it down cleanly. 10:39 to go. We're in running time, folks. Wyatt Carlson is second of the game, his third of the season. Now Connor Doyle is going to be replaced by Martin Hoffman, the senior. 10:39 to go here. On shot number 30, Hermantown scores goal number 7. They lead 7-1. Wyatt Carlson from the Kalpinen Bros. 6:21 elapsed at the time of the goal, so the Kalpinens continue to have just a huge night here at the Heritage. Again, Martin Hoffman now your goaltender. 1-1 on the year, 3.75 goals against. 8.28 save percentage, getting senior some looks here late in this one. Played near side corner, Evian in pursuit there. It's 7-1 now, tick over 10 minutes remaining. At the point, Henry Peterson loses control. Now to Luke Denfeld back. It's Caden Postal sending a shot. And it was sticked that time, I believe, by Drew Nelson. Yeah, he deflected that one into the netting. Good work that time by Nelson to get back. As now we pass 10 minutes remaining again. MSHSL running time rules. 6-goal lead or more, we will be in running time for the third period of play. Fourth line skating their first shift for the Hawks, or should I say not the entire fourth line. This one slides in front of the crease, but Andrew Johnson Jr., Rocco Erickson skating their first shifts here tonight. Not sure if Hermantown is actually dressing another fourth line skater if they went with the 7D look tonight. Evian long shot on. Hoffman saw it. Couldn't quite save it cleanly. Ends up gloving it. It'll be save number 1 of the night for Hoffman. 9:20 and counting. We got a third period of play. Hermantown 7, Duluth Denfeld 1. Scott and Freeman. Scott wins it back. Battling for a position that time was McGinn, and Swenson comes up near the Hermantown bench. Jacob Jarvie on the case that time. Near side neutral zone. Freeman trying to bank it off the glass ahead. Ends up playing it to the near side, Nolan Barker. Barker sends this one around. Kaufman plays it on the backhand. Now going cross ice. If you try to find Barker, comes free up high, 838. Barker, nice stretch pass. He finds view. Neutral ice, Andy Larson back now. Got a half step on his backhand, closes, shoots. And Garrett Upsall was knocked into the net that time. The puck stays out. Good work there by Upsall. Caden Postal was crashing as well, and that comes off. We're going to get a stoppage here. Not sure if that puck would have gone in, what the ruling would have been, had it gone in prior or after. But Upsall stayed with it the whole way. Larson, with an elite closing speed, he was in. Caden Postal tried to center it for Postal. Couldn't put it home. Upsall makes the save, his 10th of the night. Now Sunbaum's going to break it up for Evan Gunderson. Tries to feed the center. And would have been another look for Andy Larson. But he's bumped off the puck now. Duluth Denfeld controls. Both defensemen on it for Hermantown. George Peterson now for his partner, Esther Brooks. He'll play pitch and catch. Oh, no, this one's going to go off the skate of Peterson, who upends the other number 22, Caden Postal. Now Peterson up for Ford Skyda. Skyda intercepted by Andy Larson, and it comes free. Upsall's blocker side. 7:19 to go here in the third. After a tight first period of play, in which I would dare to say that Duluth Denfeld more than held their own in the first. Hermantown really pouring it on in the second and third. They put this one into running time, a little over seven remaining. That one's going to be played with a high stick. It's actually touched up by Matt Kalpinen, so we'll play on. Peterson drops it down low for Evan Gunderson. Now Ford Skyda on it. Played up to the point. Now Henry Peterson's going to walk it inside. Send a shot on. That one was deflected and played into the corner now. Into the slot. Can't find his man. Kalpinen was looking for Ford Skyda, who's now going to head off for a change. Matt Kalpinen sends it down low for Gunderson. Getting tag team there. Play to the point, Nelson. Nelson sends a shot on, misses high of Hoffman. Now Carlson into the slot. Nice save made again by Hoffman. Now one-time look for Carlson. He scores. A hat trick for Wyatt Carlson. 6:15 to go. Hermantown there, eighth of the night. Wyatt Carlson, third of the night, fourth of the season. Hermantown 8, Duluth Denfeld 1. Going to call the time of that goal 10:42, so 6:18. The time remaining, assist to Matt Kalpinen and Evan Gunderson. Matt Kalpinen, I believe a 3-point night for him. Very good showing for him, of course. Carlson, two goals and just one assist. Not anything to scoff at, to say the least. Andrew Johnson now over the line. Comes up to the point, Nolan Barker. Rocco Erickson controls it now. Erickson, Johnson was offside, they tag up. Erickson into the zone, shrugs off his man, Nolan Harju. And Denfeld working it back, Jake Farrow far side. Bowman weathers a hit from Farrow. Not able to hold the zone as Erickson, it comes free again. Now Barker for Evian. Evian. Long shot goes off for the change. Here's Erickson again. Pressure from Barker as well as Johnson Jr. Swenson to the point. Esther Brooks. Now dropping low, under five to go now. Here's Erickson. Shots 33-11 in favor of Hermantown. Find themselves leading 8-1. Now back behind McGilvery trying to break it up now. The point view through traffic to the far side corner. Will Estabrooks check that? Freeman now. Here's Estabrooks. Estabrooks sends a long shot on through traffic, gloved down nicely by Hoffman. 420 to go here in the third. Hermantown 8, Lewis Denfeld 1 on MN Hockey TV's Hockey Night in Minnesota. Up next for these two sides, Lewis Denfeld will make a trip up to the IRA Civic Center on Thursday to take on Grand Rapids, weather permitting, of course, looking at a potential snowstorm here. Here's a chance in front, puck still poked at. And boy, Mason Sundbaum almost just had a natural hat trick. Yeah, but Lewis Denfeld will go up to Grand Rapids. And for Hermantown, again, weather permitting, this one even less likely than the Rapids Gamers stick save made by Upsall. Now, Estabrook's tripped up. Moberg's going to head to the box, tripping. Hermantown will head down to face Class A Power Orono on a Thursday as well. I place the odds of that game happening at about 15%. But if it does, that should be a good one. Moberg for tripping. Of course, the running time penalty situation can always be a little bit precarious, as many fans now start file for the exits. Touch over 3 minutes remaining here. Now off the face-off, Nolan Harder trying to work it back. Upsall tries to settle it, but can't. Now a sharp angle look from John Scott will go wide, played back up to the point, Harder. Barker able to clear it, whiffing on a dump attempt as McGinn. Now here's Nelson behind the cage. Controlled by Upsall, who's been solid again here tonight. 11 saves, 12 shots. Freeman works it through on his forehand. On the forehand, is going to work it all the way around. Minute 20 left on the man advantage for Hermantown. Freeman's just going to do a figure eight up top, get it for Nelson. Now here's Barker, one touch look inside. Josh Kalbman looking for the hat trick. It comes free again, River Freeman. Puck still loose, Evian. And that one ends up in the netting. 2:08 and counting. Hermantown on cruise control here, looking to go 4-0-1. Lewis Denfeld will fall to 4-3-1. They've had a couple good results in the early going. Big win over Minneapolis, who made their first state tournament appearance last year. Upstart squad down there in the Metro. Got a couple good results, a couple not so good ones as Freeman sends one on, but still very early in the season. Still a lot of time for that team to kind of find their bearings before playoff time when the games really start counting. Near side, here's Freeman working it up high to the far side. Evan Gunderson can't slow that one down. Minute 20 left here. 12 seconds on the man advantage for the Hawks, and that will effectively end the power play chances. That one's sent all the way down. Hunter's back at full strength. I stand corrected, it was actually Postal in the box for tripping and not Mulberg. My eyes deceived me. Now here's a turnover. Luke Denfeld working it back. Jake Farrow. Farrow's shot was deflected there by Henry Peterson. Now it comes free to his blocker side. And they're going to work it back now. Freeman on the forehand. 43 seconds to go. Trying to find Bowman on the far side. He does. Puts a move on his man. Now they're going to work it down low again. 30 seconds here. Gunderson into the slot on the forehand. Blocker save made by Hoffman and a good one. Sundbaum give and go look for Skyda. Sundbaum pad save made by Hoffman. 15 seconds now. Last chance for Duluth Denfeld. On the near side, sending it on. Stick aside by Upsall. Now Peterson breaks for Skyda, 3 seconds, and that will do it here from the Heritage Center, Hermantown. A statement win over Duluth Denfeld, a rematch of last year's Section 7A title game. And Hermantown with an astounding 8-1 win here for Duluth Denfeld at the Heritage Center. Final shots, 36-13 in favor of Hermantown. 4 goals for him in the third period. 12 third period shots for a game total of 36. Lewis Denfeld, 5 third period shots, game total of 13. Final save summary for Herman Towns. Garen Upsall, 12 saves, 13 shots, and 4. I don't know if I want to do the math for Duluth Enfeld, but regardless, they had a combined total of 28 saves. Of course, Martin Hoffman going in there at the end to relieve. Third period scoring, 2:05 in. Mason Sundbaum from Aaron Evian. His first, the game first of his career, and then 2 minutes and 54 seconds later, Mason Sundbaum scored again from Evan Gunderson that time. 6:21, Wyatt Carlson is second of the game. The assist from Josh Kalpinen and Matt Kalpinen. And then 10:42, Wyatt Carlson for Matt Kalpinen and Evan Gunderson to complete the hat trick. One penalty in the third, Caden Postal tripping, 2 minutes, 13:55. And that is going to do it from here. Again, your final, Hermantown. They're going to move to 4-0-1. Hermantown 8, Luth Denfeld, who will fall to 4-3-1. Luth Denfeld 1. Thank you so much for tuning in here on MN Hockey TV's Hockey Night in Minnesota. We want to give a final thank you to all of our corporate sponsors, Affinity Plus, Federal Credit Union, St. Cloud State University, the Red Black League, and Meta Sports League. It's been a good one, folks. Thank you for staking with us here at the MN Hockey TV. Hermantown skates to a convincing 8-1 win over to Luke Denfeld. Will Peterson signing off. Take care and good night.